Dear students, today's topic is conducting polymers. It's the second topic of module 4 stereochemistry. I think all of you are familiar with polymers. In general, polymers are found to be insulators. Within the past few years, a new class of organic polymers have been synthesized, which possess remarkable ability to conduct electrical current. A polymer which can conduct electricity is conducting polymer. Examples of conducting polymers are polyaniline, polypyrrole, polyacetylene, etc. Let's move to our topic, classification of conducting polymers. Conducting polymers are broadly categorized into two: intrinsically conducting polymers and extrinsically conducting polymers. Intrinsically conducting polymers have extensive conjugation in their polymer backbone, and it is responsible for its conducting property. It is classified into two: conducting polymers having conjugation and doped conducting polymers. The first one, that is conducting polymers having conjugation, the polymers have continuous sp2 hybridized carbon centers in their polymer backbone. That means they have delocalized pi electron in their polymer backbone, and this pi electrons overlap over the entire molecule and form valence band and conduction band. The conductivity of this type of polymers is very low because the energy gap between valence band and conduction band is significant in this. Because of its low conductivity, its applications are very limited. And the conductivity of this type of polymers can be increased either by thermal activation or by photolytic activation. Second type is doped conducting polymers. These polymers are prepared by a process called doping. It is the creation of positive centers or negative centers in the polymer backbone by oxidation or reduction process. So the polymer obtained by doping process is called doped conducting polymers. And the second major class is extrinsically conducting polymers. The conductivity of this type of polymers is due to the presence of externally added ingredients in them. It is again classified into two: conductive element filled polymer and blended conducting polymers. The first one, that is conductive element filled polymer. In this type of polymer, certain conductive elements like carbon black, metallic oxides, metallic fibers, etc. are added to the polymer. Then the polymer acts as a binder to hold all these ingredients. And the second one is blended conducting polymer. These polymers are prepared by blending or mixing a conventional polymer and a conducting polymer. That's about the classification of conducting polymers. Then the conducting polymers are prepared by a process called doping. I already told that doping is the creation of positive or negative centers in the polymer backbone by oxidation or reduction. So there are two types of doping: p-doping and n-doping. P-doping is the oxidative doping. So by this process, positive centers are created. The substances which help oxidation are called the p-dopants. Examples are Lewis acids and halogens. And the other one is n-doping. It's the creation of negative centers in the polymer backbone. It is done by reduction process. So it is also called a reductive doping. It is done with the help of Lewis bases and alkali metals. Examples of Lewis bases are sodium, potassium, lithium, etc. These are also called end dopants. Now we are going to discuss the preparation properties and applications of two conducting polymers, polyaniline and polypyrrole. Polyaniline is a conjugated polymer. That means it contains alternate single and double bonds in their polymer backbone. It is also called organic metal because its conductivity and thermal dependence of conductivity are like those of semi-metals, and all other properties are like those of pure metals. That's why it is called organic metal. And it's a transparent and stable material, and it shows different colors in different state. It is prepared by the slow addition of aqueous solution of ammonium persulfate to a solution of aniline in aqueous HCl at very low temperature. The temperature ranges from 0 to 5 degrees Celsius. When these two react together, that is aniline and ammonium persulfate, a precipitate is formed. It is emeraldine hydrochloride. So this polyaniline is actually precipitated as a salt. It is called emeraldine salt. It is green in color in the conducting state. And it turns to red under reducing conditions and blue under oxidizing conditions. Next is the properties of polyaniline. It's a lightweight, highly flexible material. It possesses very high chemical resistance. It has a wide and controllable range of conductivity. It can be processed in any shapes by using ordinary fabrication methods. Next comes the applications of polyaniline. Polyaniline is used in sensors, PCB, conductive fabrics, smart windows, etc. It is used as a corrosion resistant material. And it is used as a coating film and semi-finished articles. It is used as a secondary electrode in rechargeable batteries. Next comes polypyrrole. It's an organic polymer and it is formed by the polymerization of pyrrole. Pyrrole is a 5-membered ring. And polypyrrole is prepared by polymerization of this pyrrole. Next comes the preparation of conducting polypyrrole. It is prepared by a process called p-doping. I already told that p-doping is actually an oxidation process. And the substance that help p-doping or oxidation is p-dopants. The p-dopant used here is ferric chloride. So it is prepared by treating polypyrrole with ferric chloride dopant. The product formed is conducting polypyrrole. It consists of a number of connected pyrrole rings. And it is a very good conducting polymer with conjugated double bonds. Next comes the properties of polypyrrole. Polypyrrole film is yellow in color but darkened in air due to some oxidation. And the doped and undoped films are insoluble in solvents but swellable. They are amorphous, showing only weak diffraction. They are stable in air up to 150 degrees Celsius. And polypyrrole in the oxidized derivatives and oxidized condition are good electrical conductors. Then comes applications. Polypyrrole is used in biosensors, gas sensors, anti-electrostatic coatings, lightweight rechargeable batteries, etc. It is used in carbon composites due to its excellent thermal stability. It is used for manufacturing containers for protein, so it can be used for drug delivery. The blend of polypyrrole-based polymer protects corrosion of metals. And it acts as a support for the catalyst used in fuel cells. It is used as a counter electrode in dye-sensitized solar cells. Now we are moving to an application of conducting polymer. It's OLED, organic light emitting diode. OLED is a light emitting diode. in which the MSC flare is an organic compound. Commonly used organic compound is polyfluorine, it's a polymer. And this layer emits light in response to an electric current. This emissive layer of organic semiconductor is situated between two electrodes. At least one of these electrodes is transparent. Usually anode is the transparent electrode. Next comes the principle of OLED. The principle of OLED is homo-lumo transitions. Homo means the highest occupied molecular orbital and lumo means the lowest unoccupied molecular orbitals. And these orbitals are similar to the valence and conduction bands of inorganic semiconductors. A typical OLED consists of five parts: substrate, anode, a Hall transport layer, electron transport layer, and cathode. These are the five parts. The first layer is the substrate. It is made of plastic, glass, etc. And the function of it is to support OLED. And this is the arrangement of different layers. Second layer is the anode, this positively charged electrode, and its function is to release or add halts when current flows through the device. And next is the conductive layer. It is made of a conducting polymer and its function is to transport halts from anode to the emissive layer. That's why it is called a Hall transport layer. It is usually made of a conducting polymer, polyaniline. And next layer is the emissive layer. This is an organic polymer layer. The organic polymer used is polyfluorine. And the last one is the cathode. This is a negatively charged electrode. It is made of calcium, silver, etc. And the function of it is to eject electrons when current flows through the device. That's about the construction of OLED. So it consists of five layers. First layer is the substrate that only acts as a support. And then comes the working of OLED. Okay. To light up an OLED, we simply attach a voltage across the anode and cathode. As electricity starts to flow, the cathode receives electrons from the power source and anode loses them. Now we have a situation where the added electrons makes the N-type emissive layer negatively charged, while the P-type conductive layer is becoming positively charged. Positive halts are much more mobile than negative electrons, so they jump up across the boundary from the conductive layer to the emissive layer. When a Hall electron meets recombination taking place, as a result, energy is released in the form of a quantum of light or a photon. So electron Hall recombination taking place in this emissive layer. And as a result of this electron Hall recombination, energy is released. This recombination is happening many times a second. So OLED produces continuous light for as long as current keeps flowing. It's the working of OLED. Next comes the advantages of OLED. OLEDs can be printed onto any substrate and displays can be fabricated on flexible plastic substrates. And OLEDs have a much